In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. May the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be unto you. In today's message, I want to share with you one tip that will help you in your Christian journey. One simple way that will make you know God better in the journey of Christianity. How well have you known God? Do you really know this God? Or you know about God? Because there is difference between you knowing God and knowing about God. There is difference between knowing someone and knowing about someone. Knowing about someone is when somebody tells you about him or her. But when you know someone, you don't need anybody to define or to tell you who that person is and what he or she can do. The person whom you know is the person who you can tell people about him. Is someone that you can defend, someone that you know what he or she is capable of doing. But the person that you know about is as a result of someone explaining or telling you something about that person. But the man that you know personally, it will be difficult for me or someone to tell you lies about him or her. When you know God in a person, when you have personal relationship with God, it will be better for you and it will help you to have a better communion with him. It helps you to walk with him. In John chapter 1 verse 1, where I quoted earlier, said that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So this proved that the Word of God is what you and I need to know this God. That means it is the Word of God that will tell you what God is all about. And how can you know what is obtainable, what God requires from you, if you do not study the Word of God? You will not get through your Christian life of faith without you studying your Bible. Everything you need in this life is in the Word of God. And you and I cannot succeed here on earth. You and I cannot do well here on earth without studying the Word of God, without you knowing what God says about you. The same way that fish cannot live without water, absence of water, fish will die. Just as fish cannot live without water, same way you and I cannot live without the Word of God. Water is life to fish, same way the Word of God is life to you and I. Remember that there is difference between studying and reading. If you must know God, you must study the Bible, you must study the Word of God. I didn't say you should read the Word of God, but you have to study the Word of God. In the studying, you will draw closer to Him. It's when you are studying the Scripture that you will know how to come out from some situation. It's by studying the Word of God that you will know the power that God has, and that which he also have bestowed on you as a believer. When you are studying the Word of God, don't just read through it, but rather study it. Think to yourself, what does this passage have to say concerning me? In every scripture, in every passage, there is a word for you. There is something that God is saying in that particular time. So if you didn't pay attention, you will lose it. That is why the Bible said that the letter killeth. but the Spirit of God in it giveth life. Remember that by studying, this also helped Jesus even in times of trial. In the book of Luke chapter 4 verse 4, when the tempter known as the devil came to tempt him after the fasting, and Jesus said to him, "It is written that man shall not live by bread alone." It is written is because Christ have studied, because he knows what was written. Do you know what was written in the scripture? It only takes someone that studied and know what is written in the scripture. The same way it can help you whenever you are in any situation. You will know what God said concerning that particular issue. Why you must study the scripture is because even your pastor cannot teach you everything, just like school. Your teacher can never teach you all that you need to know. They only give you a tips of it. All that you knew today, it was not your teacher that teach you everything. The same way concerning the Word of God. Your pastor cannot teach you everything, neither can we teach you everything in this channel. It takes your commitment. It takes you to study. It takes you to have personal relationship with God. Let's see what the scripture have to tell us in the book of Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. "This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success." This book of the law, what is the book of the law? The scripture shall not depart from your mouth. You shall meditate on it day and night. In other words, every second, every minute of your life, the scripture, the word of God, should not depart from your mouth as a believer. And he also said that you may observe to do, in other words, to obey all that is written therein. Then if you didn't study, how will you know what was written therein? It only takes someone who studies that we know what God says you should do and that which you suppose not to do. And he said that after you might have obeyed it, after you have obeyed the word of God, say you will have success. You will be prosperous. You will be successful in everything you do. You see, for you and I to prosper here on earth, for you and I to succeed, to be successful, we need the word of God. And we should not depend only on our pastors or any channel that we follow on YouTube or any social media. We also should dedicate ourselves in studying the word of God so that we can have a personal relationship with God. In the book of Luke chapter 4 verse 17 to 19, let's see what happened there. "And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, 'The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he had anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He had sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach the deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord.'" You see, it takes reading for Jesus to know what is required of him, for him to know his assignment, that he is sent to deliver the oppressed. He is sent to heal the blind. He is sent to set people free. If he had not read the Bible, he might have not known what he ought to do, and that he even has the power to do such a thing. So it's in the studying that you will know what God have deposited in you. Psalm 119 verse 11 said that thy word have I hidden in my heart that I might not sin against you. It's the word of God which you have studied, which you have read, the word of God which you know that will help you not to sin against God. In Ephesians chapter 6 verse 17, the Bible said, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. You see that the word of God is a weapon that you and I need to succeed here on earth. He said that the word of God is an helmet of salvation. It is also a sword of the Spirit that you and I need to succeed, to do well here on earth. Finally, let me share this with you. The first time that I heard when a man of God said that he have read the scripture from Genesis to Revelation, and he also mentioned the times, the number of times that he have studied it, I never believed it. Well, how is that possible for someone to read through the scripture from Genesis to Revelation? But by the special grace of God, I have studied it from Genesis to Revelation once, and also I have started it again from Genesis. That you have not done it does not mean that you cannot do it. And that you think you cannot do it does not mean that it is impossible. So, my beloved, I urge you to take your Bible and a notebook with pen. Start studying the Word of God today. The way I did the first time, I took 5 chapters every day. The same that I've started also 5 chapters per day. These 5 chapters per day will take me just 8 to 9 months. It will take me 8 to 9 months to cover the entire scripture. So I urge you also to start today. The Bible said now is the hour of salvation. He didn't ask you to wait until tomorrow. So I'm telling you, I'm urging you to start studying today. You can start by 5 chapters, 3 chapters, or as you think you can, depending on your schedule. The same way you schedule your time to watch Champions League, the same way you schedule your time to watch Netflix, add this also to your schedule. I will be studying Genesis chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3 to chapter 5. The next day from chapter 6 to other chapters, the other day subsequently, and you will find out that before you know, you have covered it. So that it will help you not to be manipulated. It will save you from false teaching. It will help you to do well in Christian race. If you don't have a Bible and you need a copy, you can email us on this channel and we will be glad to send you a copy. And also, heaven will rejoice because you have hunger after righteousness. And by God's willing, we will be waiting for your testimonies and we will be glad that this helps someone out there. Make it your goal to study your Bible today. Remember.